Hey guys, 1.5 hours of willful and painful ignorance. Why am I doing this to myself? And the banner hints at what is to come, saying, science, the way, the truth, question mark. Okay, I'm off to look at another video on the SCDawah channel. It's called Call In Live, science, the way, the life, the truth, question mark. Now, I'm going to analyze it, comment this, so that you don't have to. It starts off with a question by Subur, who has so often demonstrated he has no clue whatsoever when it comes to anything scientific.
Is it the case that the only root of knowledge, is it the case that science can tell us the question of God's existence with certainty or negate it? Is it the case that science gives us certainty?
Now he asks, is science the only root to knowledge or root of knowledge? I'm not quite sure what he's saying here. I can't make it out. But either would be wrong anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So, does it tell us the question of God's existence with certainty, or negate it, or does science give us certainty? Well, as they say, there are no stupid questions. Well, with one exception, this one. And I'll explain this later just now. Okay, as always, it's going to be format, presentation, contents, and impact, where I'll look some of the details in each segment and see if I can classify some of the material they provide and then come up with descriptions that will help others analyze the contents more easily. This will also show other Islam apologists and non-Muslims how incredibly easy it is to refute, debunk, and ridicule apologist claims. To help, on the other hand, the apologists, so that they can come up with more sophisticated and intellectually stimulating arguments, not this nonsense we're getting now. So instead of blocking and censoring me, they should be grateful for the service that I am providing to help them improve their standards. Right? There's two ways to look at this. Because look at it this way. If I can rip your trivial ramblings apart, so can anyone else. And it doesn't matter how often you misuse words like epistemology, transcendent, or this famous thing, which the external particularizer. Okay, so if I now apply this to the call-in stream I mentioned earlier, we immediately notice it was 1.5 hours, well, almost, of people joining a static panel of 4 Muslims, where each Muslim in turn comments on whatever comes to mind. So, to be more blunt, we have 4 Muppets without an inkling of what science is discussing science. Like they have no clue what an atheist is and constantly discuss atheists. For 1.5 hours, well, almost. That's 1.5 hours of torture, painful, pathetic, unpleasant, stop it. They are Islamic apologists, highly delusional Muslims, discussing what a video says, call in live, science, the way, the life, and the truth. Unbelievable. So we know that the first element, the call in, is not truthful, since any non-Muslim who is known to be able to challenge them is blocked, censored, unable to call in. So as a result, not a single non-Muslim or any kind of a scientist was allowed on during this entire stream. So this is 1.5 hours of mental masturbation, of just throwing things out in their echo chamber where they only got positive feedback and nobody challenged them. So then we have the word science, where we know that they don't understand it. And demonstrate this once again here, as science is not a way of life or the truth or whatever. Science is a tool, guys, come on. It's there to investigate and describe natural phenomena, which can be anything like observed or detected situations where cause and consistency are in question. The how and not the why. Science is based on facts and can lead to conclusions that compare with reality and are reliable and true, but in the form of scientific theories, which are subject to change as data gets more accurate and is updated. So science does not change. The conclusions might, as we increase accuracy and new understanding. But not science. Unbelievable. And come on, science is not equal to life and is not a way of life, nor is it a worldview. Just as a hammer is perfect for handling the problem of getting nails into something, science is perfect for explaining what is going on in the natural world, including, by the way, emotions and value judgments. But that is it. Science does not care about beliefs, sensitivities, personal preferences, opinions, or gods. We don't always need science or have time for an analytical and scientifically accurate description. A lot of times, type 1 thinking is sufficient, where the human brain can mostly rely on intuition, educated guessing, estimation, or good old instinct to arrive at remarkably correct results. But all Muslims are remarkably uneducated initially when it comes to science. And that is the reason why so few later in life take up a scientifically oriented job, and why Islamic countries contribute very little to the scientific community in general. And the effect of this we see in the video, and it's accordingly. The format is the standard stream that we know by now, where four Muslims are discussing their mutual ignorance and sometimes another panelist is allowed with limited time and highly restricted dialogue possibilities, unless, of course, it's a Muslim singing their praise, brown-nosing like I've never seen before. And the panelists are often distracted, doing other things, not really interested in what is going on. Well, at least this time we're spared the sight of someone brushing their teeth while on camera. What is actually quite annoying is the constant insertion of comments where anyone who types in "Hi, Salam Alaikum" is shown on screen while the panelists are talking. It's highly distracting and totally unusable. And as I've already noted, the content is pretty much hopeless, since this is not a discussion about anything scientific, but to show the superiority of Islam, when it's not. Because science has no explanation of why a corpse can get up and talk when slapped with a piece of steak, and Islam has. The explanation that is used for everything here, the will of an undetectable God, a miracle. Now, I will not do a running commentary here, since I would have to react and facepalm every 5 seconds, so I'll just bundle a few sentences and then comment them. So when they start off, the first question is to Mansour, not a person who's calling in to discuss these questions, which is something we do on the Jinn Tonic Show. No, here it's an echo chamber and all about mental masturbation. And the answer is pitiful, as I suspected. Now, first of all, Mansour doesn't even comprehend the question. He's not the sharpest and relies on false assertions, which he repeats loudly and thinks this is impressive. But to be fair, the question is misleading and misrepresenting non-believers, the standard kuffarophobia approach. And his answer to how he reacts to atheists when they ask him something is that he does not have an answer. He simply makes unfounded claims, where his inability to comprehend something like gravity is the foundation to conflate gravity and gods. Now, we can detect gravity, we can measure it and precisely use it in even in other fields. None of this applies to gods or goddesses. Gravity makes no demands on us, does not condone slavery or wife-beating, and many gods do. Subur now makes the most common mistake of sticking to philosophers when talking about applied science. Now, a person who talks about Professor Dawkins and his lacking philosophy is a complete idiot. He's talking to a scientist who applies biology and not someone who philosophizes, is that the right word? Who just uses philosophy and talks about something, about the meaning of biology. It's like philosophers standing around a car discussing the benefits and the possibilities of an oil change. But even if you have 50 philosophers standing around a car discussing an oil change, it still takes a mechanic to actually go and do it. So there's a benefit discussing why and where and how you should do an oil change, but at some stage you need to go down and actually go and do it. All right. Now, another thing I need to be very clear about, I don't agree with everything Professor Dawkins says, right? But I don't frantically trawl the net for negative views on him or anyone who has ever mentioned anything that goes against him. But Subur does exactly that, only that. The next question is not for someone trying to join, the way I was doing until I gave up since I'm blocked with all my accounts. Or am I? No. Imran has asked the question. Now, I will ignore it since it's simply embarrassing, as is the answer, because Imran simply does not have the brain or the mental capability to bring up something coherent or convincing. And at this point, we see on screen again this hypocritical and pretentious invitation. Why should an atheist provide an opinion they don't have? An atheist only has one opinion, that regarding gods. The atheist can be a geologist and can opine regarding geology or science in general, but not the atheist as such. Why can't they understand that? The problem is that many Muslims see science as some sort of black magic and outside their little bubble. Thus, they start making up stuff. They falsely assign science to non-believers, since most scientists are non-believers, I suppose. But I'm not a non-believer due to science. So I don't care about the Muslim obsession with the misunderstood area of science or how they misunderstand it. I just care about truth and integrity, and that's where their stupidity coupled with ignorance and arrogance gets me involved, since I care not about gods, goddesses or Muslims, but the truth. And next, a question to, well, you've guessed by now, the only remaining panelist so far, a guy called ESA, Isa. He confuses descriptive and prescriptive and simply appeals to the clouds and the trees, the antiquated design argument, which, come on, really, anyone with two brain cells functioning simultaneously can shoot down in seconds. Subur now gives us yet another display of his total and complete ignorance and childish disposition, and then we start from scratch with Mansur again. Let me apply a bit of real scientific thinking here. This is after 17 of 86 minutes, so roughly 20% of this stream have been wasted on displaying ignorance and mental masturbation, and not a single external person has managed to get through. Most probably due to the frantic screening where people like me are blocked to avoid any kind of critical thinking to creep in here. Now, is it really worth going on in this video, this pitiful incompetence and willful ignorance? Because, come on, Mansur blatantly lies. He knows he is wrong and he knows what he says is wrong. Yet he says it to deceive people. Oh, and his singing is even worse than that of hijab, and not to leave any talent unmentioned, Socrates' son. And then after 22 minutes, the first external panel member comes in, a Muslim, clueless and ignorant, who does not understand what this is all about and that it's not directed at Muslims, but atheists and scientists. And the mindless babble continues. Islam stifles thinking. It's obvious. It stifles scientific, the critical thinking. Subur spreads some more falsehoods about Al-Haytham, trying to deceive non-Muslims into believing that Islam is scientifically oriented, which it isn't, and then make science look bad to elevate the Islamic texts. Can you understand this? First they say science is bad, then they say, well, it's the Quran is scientific, the whole outlook is scientific, but science is limited, and they're constantly contradicting one another. It's quite strange. People afflicted with the Islam virus simply can't think straight. But remember, it's not even their fault. Okay, they've been indoctrinated, they've been brainwashed. They don't even realize this. Even if you give them this, they will not see this. It's I mean, Sabua says like 100 times, absolutely, absolutely, even when it's the biggest nonsense and totally false, but it's absolutely. Okay, timestamp 40 minutes, and someone joins and leaves, then another guy joins, yet another Muslim. The mods, they scream like crazy, throw out the ones who are invited and leave only the ones who are not invited, displaying yet more the result of an Islam virus brain. Hypocrites. This is all that it is. And it's actually quite sad when Islam apologists come up with how primitive their understanding of nature is. It's now half time, and not a single atheist or scientist was allowed on to challenge these fools. After soldiering on and listening to the obtuse sycophants going on and on and on how brilliant these guys on the panel are, and then I heard a totally deluded Muslim, a trucker in the US, and he says, and this, I think he admits this even, they need SCDawah to tell the people what everything is, because the people are simple, and that's all we need to understand. It's not about accurate, correct, or reliable information. It's about simple, even primitive claims brought forward with confidence, and simple-minded, credulous people will believe anything, even an ant speaking Arabic. And that ends the SCDawah live call-in stream for atheists and scientists or whatever. Not a single one was allowed in, not one. Instead, we just got the same old nonsense in an echo chamber where everyone agrees with this bullshit and nobody really knows what they're talking about. It's sad, just sad. Now, imagine the claim of Islam growing if this were true. What would life be like? Imagine if really Islam grows and takes over this planet. This would be a nightmare. Let's hope that people learn what science is instead. Thanks for your time. See you in the next video.